afternoon, good evening, family. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Mental House with me, your host, Khadija. Oh boy, I haven't quite resolved my camera issue, but it's coming, you guys. Just bear with me. We'll get some better quality because I'm looking at the videos and I just appreciate y'all hanging with me because I know it's rough, but we'll have it, I think, rectified very, very shortly. But what I wanted to make sure I got on here and talked about was, first of all, let me first and foremost give a shout out to Tyrese and the fact that, he wasn't estranged from his daughter. However, with that being said, I hope he will take this opportunity to deal with what we all have, which is residue from our childhood issues. And the reason why I want to speak on that to this brother specifically is because there's a few things, I hear a lot of people, either making fun or jumping to the conclusion that he's just a narcissist. He's a narcissist. Like I said, most of us who are in show business have narcissistic traits. Now, whether we are flat out narcissists is a whole different ball game. And I don't want to get into those labels because they do disturb sometimes the whole heart of the matter. Like I've said before, most people who are in the entertainment business, whether they're a musician, an actor, whatever, artist, visual artist, there's a certain amount of narcissistic traits that they must have in order to chase a dream the way that we do or have, So that's not the issue. The issue is when you have no empathy, okay, for anyone else. Because a lot of times what we see as narcissism may not be narcissism. It may be just, again, the traits. And it could be a severe codependency, all these labels. But what I want you to look at it, and why I try to look at it, because I'm not a psychiatrist. I'm not a psychologist. But as the giver and the receiver, and how life should be a give and take type of situation, whether it's emotionally, whether it's physically, it should be give and take, give and take. So some things you don't need to have a degree about. It's what your heart feels. Okay, and there's certain things, and I say that, but now if your heart has been wounded and your programming has been defected, a lot of times the way you respond is a direct result of that abuse. Okay? Now, let me give for instance, and I'm trying to, there have been times that myself, I have reacted to situations before I really knew what this narcissism stuff was about, part of myself. There was sometimes issues that I may have reacted to in a certain way. Or I said, I'll never go back with that person again, or I'll never do that again. Okay? Knowing whatever drama this person or that situation brought me, and no matter how adamant I was about it, it was like 6 months later, I might have went back to the same situation. And I know I'm not the only person who has, done that. How many people can take a situation, know it doesn't work, and then just keep it moving? Okay? Maybe to a degree where they can still remain friends with an individual, not per se friends, but maybe just, hi, how you doing? But then there are some people that squeeze every bit of respect and love out of the relationship because of the drama that the relationship has produced. So when I think about people that are in these kind of relationships, and the first thing I do, like I do for myself, I go back, okay, what does that remind me of, you know, from my healing, my journey? And so I might think, okay, what kind of behavior? Not that I'm trying to diagnose that person, but I try to find out if there's some similarities in some of the behaviors that, because they run so like a needle and thread through that could, a tie that binds it. In other words, if you have an abusive mother, a mother who was severely codependent, or if you was brought up with a drug addict parent or alcoholic parent, there are certain attributes to your behavior that's going to be common with everybody else that has been raised by those type of people. How you see relationships, how you respond to relationships, how even if you have a codependency type of behavior because your parent might have always put you in an embarrassed type of situation, maybe by spanking you out in front of your friends, maybe by humiliating you in front of people. You grew up with a grid, maybe that you're a little more codependent. Maybe you think people are your friends that who really aren't your friends. You have a demeanor about yourself where you think everything is, these are all, you quick to, you know, oh, this my guy. You quick to say, oh, that's my friend. I see. Now, it depends on the damage. The more easier you are to say something like that when the other person might not feel that way about you because they may be healthier and they might be saying like, well, okay, we work together, but, you know, you're not all that. I mean, why are you acting like? And I know y'all probably saying, where am I going with this? Just follow me. They might be saying, why are you acting like this? That's kind of how I felt like when he was going in on The Rock. I kind of felt like The Rock has a healthy demeanor about himself. You know, he has a total different background. He has a more secure background with a mother and a father and a very give or take. Don't get me wrong, there's no perfect family, but I know that his family structure was a lot different than Tyrese being raised by a crackhead and a mother who used drugs and was an alcoholic. And I know the damage that being raised in those kind of households exhibit. And it could be the same thing for a person that has, because when your parent is an alcoholic or a drug addict, they create an environment for the child that is insecure. Okay? And so that's what I kind of felt like about Tyrese. And then when I heard a tirade, a lot of guys were making fun of him. And then a lot of people were saying, oh, he must really love his child because no man will get on, you know, and there were a lot of people, rightfully so, that said, well, he's an actor. So all these opinions were correct to some degree. I just feel that at the end of the day, I'm looking at all of the issues. How he sees his friendships with other people and that may not necessarily see him that way. And that's one of the main things that a person that is... have damage from abuse, the way they see the world, you know, so they can cry, so they can be not, you know, cry literally, but so how they can, they see the world through that kind of lens, and it makes it easy to lash out at somebody when they don't feel like they're getting their way. They haven't been taught how to use a spirit of discernment. And a lot of, they don't have healthy boundaries, because a lot of people would have handled that situation with Rock a totally different. A healthy person might have been pissed that Rock did that, but they would have came back with in their mind like, okay, well, let me still be chilled about this because, you know, hey, maybe I can ask the Rock, you know, or say, hey, look, man, you know, I got an agent too, but if you got anything you think, you know, rolling for me in this little, you know, piece, I'm open. Whereas you're continuing to create opportunity as opposed to let your emotions get in the way of something bigger. And so all that kind of wrapped up to me with our own and my own, dysfunction. Because I remember a time in my life where, you know, I would really get angry when I thought that, especially being the Aries, that, you know, it's probably one of my weaknesses, but I would get totally pissed off if a person in my circle disagreed with me. It was almost as if I thought that they were giving me the ultimate sign of betrayal. Okay? And it was something that really wasn't tolerated. Except I couldn't be that same Billy Badass in my interpersonal relationships, right? Because there was all kinds of disrespect and all kinds of things that just shouldn't have been happening in when you're supposed to be relating to someone. It shouldn't have been happening on that interpersonal level. And I had to find out for myself, why was I allowing this to happen? And then how does that affect the way I react to things? You know? So what I hope out of this whole thing with Tyrese, because I don't know who's the narc, I don't know if Norma is bipolar, and I don't know if Tyrese is, I know he's got narcissistic traits, and as you know, and I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with that to the degree that that's, you have to have a certain amount of that to keep the edge, to be focused. But when you don't have feelings and you don't have empathy, and if it's true that, you know, you do things that you know that you should acknowledge that it may be something that you saw from your childhood, or the way you're handling this situation might have been how you saw your mama handle something because you didn't have a role model for a dad. And if you are not willing to take responsibility or get in touch with that, this is not going to be the end of you and Norma's craziness regarding y'all beautiful daughter. So I hope, as an elder states person, what I said makes some kind of sense. You know, I just said what I said to try to bridge the gap in somewhat, and hopefully that my words are not venomous, and that they touch somebody out there. Okay, somebody out there know what I'm talking about. So with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead. I'm gonna leave you, and I'll be back a little later in the mental house. Unfortunately, I have about 4 videos that I thought loaded up. Y'all, I have senior moments. I just want you to know that, right? And they're still sitting there. And the reason they're still sitting there, that's another whole video. I'll tell you about that later. But I don't even know if I should load them up now, because, you know, they were there obsolete. So with that being said, I have to work a little bit harder today, right? Okay, like what you hear, please like, subscribe, and share. And I thank you for being out there, whatever side of the diaspora that you on. Thank you for being here. Thank you for participating. Please comment, like the video, share the video if you think it's worth sharing, but please like and subscribe if you haven't. Hit the bell so when we do something else, you can be notified, okay? All right, family. See you next time in the mental house.